wood trim came in for this yesterday. It wasn't supposed to come in till today, but came yesterday, not complaining. And because it came in yesterday, I got home late at night and decided to put these in on the door panels because I was super anxious and sized and I just wanted them in. So there you go, I'm very impatient. But now I have the dash bezel and the center console to do. So I'm gonna go inside, clean those up, and then we'll put them in the car. All right, this is the piece that I was worried about. It seems to be in pretty good shape though. I mean, that's kind of gross there, missing this piece, but it's okay. I'll just snag that out of the other one. Same with the clock, it's missing that. And then mine does not have this. So I'm hoping that's all the same. I hope. I'll be a little butthurt if it's not, because I can't just not connect the little airbag. Yeah, I can't really just leave that disconnected. As a matter of fact, it can cause a whole lot of issues, so we'll see. In mine, the little four-wheel drive lever boot is broken, but that's okay because I have an entire new centerpiece. It's still black, but it's okay. Time to take this part out. I also disconnected the battery because I read somewhere that it's really, really, I mean, you can just have a lot of issues if you disconnect the passenger airbag light with the key on. So power going to anything in the car. That's what I've heard. I don't know if that's entirely true, but I figured I would just do it because what's the worst that could happen? I mean, nothing's gonna happen if the battery's disconnected. I just figured I'd rather be safe than sorry. All of the center trim is out and I'll have to go double check, but it looks like that's the same plug. I hope, pray to God. So this should technically be a direct fit, but we'll see. Okay, both trim pieces are right here in front of me and it is indeed the same exact connector. So now it's time to just get to cleaning this one. Okay, got it cleaned up, got the clock switched over, that little ashtray, and it's ready to go in the car. But before I do that, when I install my radio, I totally forgot to put the microphone in so I can take calls over Bluetooth. I also forgot to put the little GPS antenna in, and I don't know if I'll need this, but it was in my last 4Runner, so we'll see. I'm a little upset with myself because I have the parts 4Runner and I never grabbed one of the screws off that. Now I still have it, but it's like the fact that I'll have to take this dashboard off now, or this center console out now again to put that extra screw in there, but I'll go ahead and snag it anyway, just have it off to the side. I'm sure I'll have the center console out at some point again. I'm always tearing this thing apart. Got the dash bezel out and this little security Toyota, whatever, the little blinking light pretty much is all that it is. Got that out of there. So I'll put this in the other dash bezel and then get those pieces into the car. Alrighty, the 4Runner's interior is finished and I could not be happier with the way that it turned out. Oh my goodness. Yeah. Birdman, Junior, so fresh, Drizzy Drake.